Council or a politician around in years that has done more for public housing estates and the people that live in them. We've had rats problems, we've had problems all over the place, we've had renovations problems, we've had people on the streets, and you can call Steve Jolly up at 2 o'clock in the morning and guess what, he'll answer the phone and try to help you out. And there's a lot of people down at public housing estates in Fitzroy, in Collingwood, in Richmond that are starting to realise that the usual politics just doesn't work anymore. And there is a new wind, a new breeze coming up, and I think Steve Jolly's going to do very well this election. I hope he does, and we all hope he really does well. And thanks, Steve.
What history has proved is that Steve Jolly's been right on all the big issues. Public housing, public education. He's talked about the illegal war in Afghanistan and Iraq. He's stood his ground. He hasn't been like the spineless politicians that we've had representing us over the years. It is time for a change. It is time for someone who has the courage of their convictions to be elected. And I want you all to give generously. We need to provide financial support for Steve. He's a person who puts his money where his mouth is. And I want you to all support him as hard as you can. Cheers.
Every time my daughter has a fight with me, she points to that poster and says, "You'll never live that off." But look, it's quite clear, going around the last few weeks, knocking on doors, public meetings on the housing estates, amongst the other parts, the 80% of people who don't live in public housing estates in the city of Yarra, that people are looking for a change from the major parties. People, especially young people, are really jacked off with the Labour Party and with the Liberal Party. Hazelwood, the reason they're not going to act on Hazelwood is because the polluters are bankrolling the Labour Party and the Liberal Party, and we have the worst power station on the continent, probably in the Western world, that will not go as long as we don't smash up the two-party system. That's quite clear. The reason that they're not doing anything about public transport, which is an absolute disgrace in this city, even where you live in, we'll say the suburb of Richmond, where you've got three tram lines east-west, you've got one tram line north-south, there's not enough trains and there's not enough trams and there's not enough buses on the lines that currently exist. But for whole numbers of people in this city, young people who are coming into this city to Brunswick Street, Smith Street, Swan Street or the city, they have to leave early because there's whole suburbs in this city that don't have access to public transport. We're the only city probably in the Western world that doesn't have a train line to the airport. Our loop is a disgrace, it's tiny. Can you imagine if we had a government that pumped serious money into public transport, that expanded the loop, had a railway line to the airport? How many jobs would that create? How good would that be for the environment if everybody had the basic human right, not just to health and education, but to public transport? And the reason that they won't do anything for that, Labour Party or Liberal Party, is that the oil, car and road lobby bankroll those parties and they stop it. The argument is not scientific. The reason it's not happening is not scientific, but it's political. And that's why we've got to smash the two-party system. It's quite clear. So when you go to the polls, you have to say that the only genuine progressive alternative in the state seat of Richmond that won't get into bed with the Labour Party, that won't get into bed with the Liberal Party, is the Socialist Party, is my candidature and our party on the 27th of November. And you need to tell your friends that. And the support that we've got over the course of the last few weeks has been really, really humbling. We know for a fact that the Christian Sudanese community have come in strongly behind the Socialist Party for November 27th. We know that the Chinese community, who've always been a strong support for the Socialist Party, are split in two. The people who support us are staying with us. Last week we had meetings, it was reported on in the Sunday Age last week, the pro-Labour Party Chinese groups have now come behind the Socialist Party on November 27th. Tonight, one of the reasons I was late to this thing tonight was that I was meeting at the Housing Week with the Muslim African community. They've also decided to come in behind our candidature in 2 weeks' time. And the reason is because of what Brandon said. Because we're not just coming up at election time and saying, vote for us, we're going to fix all your problems. But we'll be there on the ground for years and years and years, fighting with them over the cockroaches, over the rats, over the dodgy refurbishments, over the dodgy maintenance, and we will be there after the election, whether we're in power or whether we're not in power. But also, more importantly, or equally importantly, amongst the 80% of the people who aren't public housing tenants, we're getting loads of support because of our position on planning, on transport, and on the environment. And I'm very, very confident that we're going to do really, really well, but we need you to support us. The last point I want to make is, what would we do if we won this seat? And this is, I suppose, another clear difference. And by the way, one of the things you can also do is word of mouth. Because we've brought out loads of leaflets, we've had loads of meetings, we've door knocked in loads of houses. But people like you, most of whom are not members of the Socialist Party, talking to people and saying, we want to support this ticket, has huge impact on Twitter, on Facebook. I was going to say MySpace, but that would give away my age, because that's, my daughter tells me, is like really naff nowadays. But you need to get out and say to people, if you're young, I know you're pissed off at the Labour Party, and I know you don't want the Liberals back, but there's a difference between the Greens and the Socialist Party. We're not going to go into bed with the Liberals, we're not going to go to bed with the Labour Party, but the other difference is this. On council, the reason that we've been successful on council, even though we've only had one vote out of nine, is that when a group of women come to us and say, our childcare centre is getting closed, when a bunch of people come to us and say, somebody's going to put a 12-storey apartment next to my single-storey house, when somebody comes up to us and says, we've got cockroaches all over our high-rise estate, public housing estate, and the Labour Party will do nothing about it, we don't just advocate in the media and at the council meetings on their behalf, we organise them with petitions and public meetings, and then we bring them down to the town hall, and we terrorise the Greens and the Labour Party and the right-wing independents, and that's how, it's like a pro forma, that's how we do what we do, and that's why we've been successful. Because at the end of the day, if you think that by voting socialist, you're going to, on November the 27th, and even if I won, that we're going to fix all these problems up, you're dreaming. Because real politics comes from the street. The right for the women to vote, for Aboriginal people to vote, the right, you know, in the Eureka Stockade onwards, everything that we enjoy today, in the building industry, the conditions, has come through struggle. So if I win this seat, one of the things I'll be doing is only accepting the average wage of a skilled worker. That's a position that the Socialist Party has got here and all over the world. And what will we do with the rest of that money? Not only with the money, but with the four staff we would have and the office that we would have. We would, yes, of course, we would use the position to advocate to close down Hazelwood, to advocate for a massive expansion of public transport and all the rest of it, but we would mobilise. We would use that money, we would go to the unions, we would go to the community organisations and say, let's go at Easter to Hazelwood for 4 days with 5,000 young people from Melbourne, and let's stay there until we closed it down like we did at Woomera at the start of this decade, like we did at Baxter, like we did every time George Bush came to this city. We would use that position to mobilise people. Our office would be an organising tool for the entire left, for the union movement, for rank and file groups, for community organisations, for gay and lesbians, fighting for same-sex marriage. That's what we would do. And that would be the difference between what we're doing and what the Greens are doing, which is essentially parliamentary creditism. Vote for us and we'll fix all your problems. I think it's really important you get the difference in the project of what we're trying to build and what the Greens and the Labour Party and everyone else is trying to build. It's a very, very different project. And that's why I would say to you today that if you're here today as an interested person, you're going to vote or help the campaign, that's absolutely fantastic. We need your time, we need your money, we need your support. Help us on the pre-poll, help us on election day, give us your money, give us your time, get involved in the struggle for social change. On behalf of the Socialist Party, I'd like to say thank you for coming and thank you for being here tonight. Thank you.